What's up? I'm Darren. It's another edition of Offseason Chatter. And this time we are appreciative of Nick Martinez for joining us, Olympic silver medalist, native of Miami, Florida, longtime pro at this point, who we hope to see in an MLB organization sometime soon. I don't think we're going to be breaking news on this edition of Offseason Chatter, but Nick, what's going on? How are you?
It's good to see you. How's it going, Darren? Yeah, same here, man. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, let's start with the silver medal. A lifetime's accomplishment, right? Not many people are able to say, I have a silver medal from the Olympics. I know this was something that back in the qualifying process, it was important for you as we sort of whittled down our roster to make this team and all those good things. What did you get out of the process that sort of resonates with you on a day-to-day basis today here at, as we near the end of
2021? Well, I mean, first of all, I still got to like sit back and just think about, you know, how cool it is to have a silver medal and to even just be a part of this Olympic team, to be able to have the opportunity to wear the uniform and represent the country. I mean, it's something that you dream of as a kid and you know, to see it come into fruition, it's hard to describe. And, you know, one of the things, I think, obviously one of the things that stands out is, you know, walking the opening ceremonies. That's obviously very special. It's something that as a kid, that was something that you tuned into every 4 years or every 2 years, even during the Winter Olympics. That's something that is very special to me even to this day.
Yeah. I want to talk about Eddie Alvarez because you guys grew up friends, both baseball players obviously, but had never played on the same team together because you went to rival high school. So the first time you guys were actually teammates was with this Team USA squad. What was that like? Did you guys talk at all about that possibility and the lead
up? Yeah, we did. So, you know, I've known Eddie, like you said, since I was about 10, 11 years old. We went to the same baseball academy, and because of my age, I'm young for my class. So I played at the lower, the age below him. Yeah. On our travel ball team, we played the same academy, but he played a year older than me. So we never played together. We played at the same academy, and then we went off to different high schools. We went to my rival high school. So we didn't, and at that time we didn't start playing each other until right after. So they're only a rival high school because they're the only other all boys school in Miami, but they're a different class. So they're at a, I think at the time 6A, I was a 3A. I think it goes in Florida, it goes all the way up to like 8A now. But
yeah, okay.
We never played with each other. We always played against each other. And when he told me he made the Olympic team, and I told him I was, you know, I'd throw my hat in the ring to be selected. And it was just real cool that he was one of the first people I called when I made the team.
Nice. Very cool. Very cool. Well, let's talk about Japan and the experience with this Team USA, because you're not the only one that was on the roster for whom this was the case, but you guys were playing in an area that you had become pretty familiar with because your professional career took you to Japan. Was it easier? Did that make it easier? Did that make it different? Did that, you know, calm you down maybe a little bit?
I think, I'm sure there was a sense of familiarity with it. I think it would have served us better if there were fans. We would have known how to react to fans being in the stands, maybe a little bit better than the other guys on the team. But I think maybe there's a little bit of familiarity having lived in Japan, you know, me, Tyler, and Scott, having lived in Japan, just maybe the day-to-day operations of going to practice, you know, maybe sitting in traffic for a little bit or getting to a facility, how to get into our routines a little bit easier and a little bit quicker. I think that might have been easier for us three. But I think it would have served a bigger purpose if we had fans there.
Yeah. Now, obviously, the ultimate goal was gold heading in. And, you know, at some point after the fact, you've got to sort of come down from the disappointment of not winning gold. And understand the realization, kind of like what you were alluding to earlier, that, you know, not many people get the opportunity to earn a silver medal at the Olympics. Yeah. What was that like in the final ceremonies for you guys? Were you still, was the general vibe still like a little bit of disappointment, but appreciative? What was the mix?
I think it was a good mix. I mean, obviously we wanted gold, and I think we didn't leave anything on the field. And I think when a team plays that way, there isn't much regret. And I feel like I truly believe that that's how we played, you know, the first two times against Japan. We left it all out there and they beat us. So that's a little bit of an easier pill to swallow. A little bit disappointing, but we were still, I think, overall appreciative of the ceremony, how well we were accepted by that team and by the fans that were there, you know, they're not fans, but the people working the games, and they had some volunteers at the game looking over and taking care of us. And I think the overall feeling was a feeling of appreciative.
Mm-hmm. Well, one of the lines that we like to use here at USA Baseball is own the off season. So I know you're traveling, you're getting physicals done, you're trying to get them sent off to potential teams. So that's one way I assume you are owning the off season.
I'm training right now. So
yeah,
I only take about a week off and then I get back into it. Yeah. So I definitely own the off season when it comes to that.
Well, what's that look like for you? Maybe a little bit more specifically, how much is devoted to, you know, physically getting stronger, getting faster, that sort of thing? Or do you take a little bit more time off from throwing? How does that all look?
So, I mean, it's pretty easy. I don't take too much time off, not even from throwing. I'll probably just keep the arm moving. I don't start long tossing right away, but I have a general progression that I do, I started it this month, and then my workouts are similar too. I don't go right into a heavy strength training. I try to hone it back in, maybe start off with a lot of stabilization drills, one-legged strength and core strength, trying to tighten everything back up. And then when it comes to throwing, just my shoulder, just kind of keep it moving around pretty early, at least for the first month. Just keep it moving, nothing too strenuous.
Yeah. I'm always curious, Nick, too. To what degree, I mean, you were drafted back in 2011, so you've been a pro baseball player for a decade plus now at this point. To what degree do you change much in the offseason in bigger ways, right? Like if you're trying to get signed or your current team suggests, hey, you got to get better in these ways. From off-season to off-season, how much is devoted to, rather than regular maintenance, right, and just the general process of taking care of your body and making sure that you can deliver in the same ways you did the season before, how often are you adding things to your repertoire?
Learning
a new pitch or whatever?
Constantly. I mean, I like to keep that curiosity of getting better and learning and finding new ways to get that edge. You know, I wasn't born with an arm to throw 100. It seems like everywhere you look now, there's a kid throwing 100 or 100.
They're
plus
everywhere, man. Right?
Nasty slide or curveball. So I have to find an edge some way. So I'm always looking for ways to get better, whether it's, you know, recovery to a new pitch or pitch design or mental strength, you know, working on meditations or whatnot, and try to slow the mind down and gain some clarity to physical strength. And like I said, learning new pitches or bettering some pitches. I mean, any way that I can gain an edge, I'm definitely looking for it.
Yeah. No, that's a mindset I respect and appreciate. But let's move on. Holiday talk, because those are coming up, right?
Yeah.
Those in need of gifts, usabaseballshop.com. Keep that in mind. What are some of your favorite holiday memories? Let's take it back. Like 10-year-old Nick Martinez.
Yeah.
This time of year, what were you most excited about?
We look forward to Christmas Eve. So Latin culture, we love what we call Noche Buena, which is the Christmas Eve it's like our huge family gathering, our American version of Thanksgiving, our version of the American Thanksgiving. And it's a huge party. We roast a couple of pigs, get the whole family together. And it's a really, really big night. It's my favorite. And I'm glad baseball's not in the winter because it's my favorite holiday.
So is that something you still take part in with the
There's always a big there's always some sort of argument that forms because I got to go to my wife's side of the family, then I got to go to my side of the family, and I want to get to my side a little bit quicker. So there's always a little argument that we get into every year, but we end up making it work out.
Yeah. So you'll spend your holidays in similar ways, right? I would imagine, whether you're back in Japan or wherever your professional baseball playing takes you.
Yeah, yeah.
That won't come until a little bit after. So that's nice that you'll have that time with
yeah, family. That's what's nice. Yeah, the baseball season allows me to be home for these holidays. So even if I go back to Japan this year or stay home, I'll get to enjoy the full holidays. Yeah, for sure.
Nice. What do you remember in terms of, gift giving and gift receiving when it comes to maybe something that's baseball specific? Maybe you got a cap from your favorite team.
As a kid growing up, I always asked for baseball stuff for Christmas. So that was something that I absolutely needed to have on my Christmas list. And whether it be a bat or a glove or a hat, a bucket of baseballs, whatever it might be, I just wanted something new for baseball.
What was your all-time favorite, the one you got most excited about? That might be dependent too on your age or what the specific gift was.
I mean, anytime I asked for a new glove, that was the most exciting thing for me. Even to this day, when I get a new glove, I don't get them only on Christmas anymore. So every day I get a new glove. Every time I get a new glove, it feels like Christmas, and it's something that, it's my favorite day of the season, really, to get a new glove is great.
Yeah. What's the first thing you do to try to break one in?
I like my gloves a little bit on the stiff side, so I don't do too much to break them in, but I'm definitely playing around. I have it molded in my hand already, and throwing a ball against the walls, I still do that as I did when I was 6 years old, as early as I can remember. Get a new glove, go to the backyard, throw a ball against the wall and break it that way. I still do that to this day.
Is that one of those things too, where you're breaking in a new glove and you just have it on your hand all the time?
Oh yeah.
You walk around, somebody's like, "Hey, can you give me a hand with this?" I'm like, okay. Well, I guess for a minute.
Actually ask someone else is what I usually say. So I can't hand it. I can't help you out. I'm breaking a new glove.
This mold's got to be perfect, right?
It's got to be perfect. Yeah,
that's great. I mentioned the USA Baseball Shop. I know you frequent the USABaseballShop.com site and like to stock up on gear. What from the holiday collection catches your eye this year? What is Nick Martinez going to have under his tree?
I got the Christmas tree ornament. The USA. It was like the ornament ball.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got that when we were in Cary training. I was like, I know I'm going to be home for the holidays. And so I was already, July?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was July, and I was already looking forward towards the Christmas spirit. So.
Man, so you don't miss around. So Christmas is a really big deal to you then.
It's a big deal for us. Yeah. It's we're the only time we're home, 4th of July is another big one, but I've been in Japan the last 4 years, so I haven't been able to celebrate as well as I wanted to.
That's great. This you can answer this last one, Nick, however you would like, whether it's something that happens in your life, an actual physical thing. What is the one thing on your holiday wish list this year? Like what would you like more than anything?
I don't know. I don't think I can answer that. Our holidays now consist of getting my daughter stuff. So
right.
I think what I want for the holidays is my daughter to get a full understanding of Santa Claus. I think this might be the first year we get that. Last year we tried a little bit. She's only three last year.
Yeah.
She was just 2 years old and she couldn't quite grasp that Santa Claus comes and leaves you gifts and just happens once a year. So I think that this year she'll finally get it and kind of understand what Christmas is about and what Santa, you know, brings to the house.
That's cool. No, because then it becomes more of a big deal, right? To the kids.
Yeah, because I think what's more exciting now is like, right. I think more is the excitement on her face. I want to see what she, you know, wakes up to waking all those presents, and I want to see that more than anything.
That's a really good answer to your holiday wish list question. That's perfect. Well done. Well said. Nick Martinez, congrats on the success with Team USA. We're proud of that silver medal, as we know you are individually.
Yeah, absolutely.
Best of luck, whatever next season holds for you. I know there are a number of possibilities and you're keeping your options open right now. So whether it's with a major league team here stateside or back in Japan, we know you'll do great things. We're happy to have you as part of the Team USA family now. So best to you and
yours. It's an honor to be a part of it. Thank you so much.
And we'll catch up again soon. All right.
Sounds good. Thanks, Darren. Yeah. Thanks for having me.